There are many blocks in Scratch, but which one of them is the most underrated? So I'm gonna go through 5 and you in the comments will decide which one's the most underrated. So let's get right into it. The first block I think is underutilized is the mod or modular block. So whenever you see this block, you might be thinking it's like a complicated math block and it's gonna be like super confusing and stuff like that. But it's actually super simple. So basically, it's just a remainder of a division. So I mean by that is, for example, 10 mod 4, 2 fours fit in 10, and 2 will remain. Okay, so 2. And then let's go for like 5, and nothing will remain. But if we go, let's say 11, 1 will remain. Now, how is this actually useful? Well, let me show you how. So we can just get a variable in here, and let's say the mod 20. Now, this will be basically the cap of the variable. When it will exceed this, it will go back to 0. So you gotta set my variable to my variable mod 20, change my variable y1, get out my favorite block, the forever loop, when green flag clicked, and finally make my variable showing. Okay, so we have it over there. Let's click on the green flag and we can see it goes to 20 and restarts. To make it much clearer, let's say 100, and you can see it goes all the way up to 100 before starting again. Okay, on to number 2, the timer block. Now you might be thinking, well, I use the timer block, but you don't use it to its full potential. So how is the timer block that useful? Well, it's basically like a variable that goes on forever. So normally you'd put change my variable by 1 in a forever loop with a when green flag clicked. But you don't need that, you only need this block. I even made a tutorial with it. And there's some other cool uses with this. For example, even if you stop the project, the timer won't stop. So this allows you to make things like the when stop sign click detector. Alright, now on to the third one. In my opinion, this one is the most underrated of them all. And most people don't even know this exists. Because if you go in here, it looks like backdrop of stage. But what's the difference? Well, you can actually go to all the sprites. And in the sprite, you can get any sprite's X position, Y position, direction, costume number, costume name, size, and even volume. Now, most people, when they have to do this, they make a separate variable, and it just gets pretty confusing. But this, when I heard about this, I was just mind blown. This is one of the best blocks in Scratch, to be honest. Number 4 is a divide block. Now, you might be thinking, Steamis, you ran out of ideas. The divide block is not underrated. Everybody uses it. Well, I bet you didn't know that you can make super smooth movement with it. So let me show you how. Just drag this mouse X and get out to minus. Now here you can do like divide by 3 and let's do mouse X minus X position. Now we'll change X by this and again forever loop. When green flag clicked, and now we have to show this, and let's hide the first sprite. And look at that, guys, that is so smooth, and you can even change it, for example, like divide by 2, and it just follows your mouse more. Okay, next one. Now this one is the save block, and this is widely regarded as a beginner block, because you see it in beginner projects, just like saying the instructions, or like some story projects or something from like the Scratch team. And mostly beginners use it, but advanced programmers can use it too. And this is how. Basically, when you're working with clones, it can be frustrating to find out what each of them have, like their X position, their Y position, and if they have like local variables, then good luck finding the problem. But with the save block, you can find out what they're saying really easily, and you can just see it on the screen. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see more Scratch tips, then click on this video.